Okay, so today I'm interviewing with Professor Sealy Winston. How are you?
Good, good. How are you doing, Jacqueline?
I'm good, I'm good. So you have been my advisor and professor since I started here at Minnesota State University in Mankato. And the reason I wanted to meet with you today is because you've been a great inspiration for me since I started here, and I believe you have a such great interaction with students. And so I'm gonna ask you a few questions. Just so prospective students can kind of like tell what you're doing and also what our department are like. So,
Excellent.
do you want to tell me what department you're teaching for?
So I'm in the Automotive Manufacturing Engineering Technology program, and I teach primarily in the manufacturing side of the department.
What courses are you teaching right now?
Currently, I'm teaching this semester, I'm teaching the Advanced Parametric Modeling course. I'm teaching a course in automation for manufacturing. I'm also teaching a lab course for finite element analysis. And I'm also doing a grad class in computer-aided engineering using mechanism and physics to process and calculate motion, etc.
Okay. Yes, you're teaching graduates as well as undergrads at our
Yes,
department.
correct. Yeah.
Yeah. So one of my favorite courses was the parametric modeling and also the automation. It's about CAD. So we use Creo and we design a lot of stuff. And the automation class was a lot about programming, which was completely new for me, but it was really interesting and fun. And I really
And you
enjoyed
did
both
well.
courses. Yeah.
Good, good. I
So,
know you were a little hesitant in
yeah, because
the automation class,
it seems like a lot the first time you see it, but then
but
it's so fun. So you catch up pretty fast, which is
yeah,
neat.
it is a fun class. It's one of
Yeah.
my favorite classes.
Yeah. So, how long have you been teaching at MNSU?
I've been teaching here for about 10 years now.
Okay.
I came in as a pre-doctoral fellow, and I worked on my PhD and then got hired as a tenure professor.
Oh, wow. And what is your favorite part about teaching at Minnesota State?
I would say my favorite part is, and it may sound cliche, but I think it's the students and that moment. Considering that everyone learns at different levels and have different styles, one of the things I like to reinforce is my teaching style is not just one predominant style. My goal is to use a bunch of different teaching styles to reach as many students as possible. So it's kind of like a probabilities game. I normally call it probability of convergence. Bunch of different things, and then you reach as many students as possible.
Yeah, that's something I really agree with you as a professor, having you as my professor, how you see all students and meet their levels and kind of like not have one teaching style and want everyone to adapt to after. And it's really helped me and it shows that you really, get involved with students and want them to learn. So,
Oh, definitely.
yeah. And also something I appreciate with the professors here at Minnesota State is that it's more about the teaching and interaction with students, rather than some universities and colleges when it's more focused on just the research part kind of thing. So yeah, I really enjoy that office hours and like one-on-one like we're having here now that you get to spend time and get to know each other as well.
Yes, agreed.
So what makes Minnesota State so unique?
I think, kind of like you mentioned, the emphasis on students, that's one. Two, we are located in a quaint little town called Mankato. And there's a lot of nature and natural stuff to do if you a person who enjoys hiking and camping, etc. Also, we have the seasons. The seasons are maximized. We have the coldest winters and the hottest summers.
Yeah.
It's So it's an in-between, you have the transition season. So it's I think, ideal for someone who enjoys extremes, I would think.
Yeah, I agree. So you mentioned like hiking and stuff as activities. How can students get involved in department activities outside classes?
So as far as activities, so students could request to work with professors, either on research, and through that research, there's also team building type activities that could be done, professors normally do. So that's one, I guess, one example where students could work with professors and also do things externally. There are also different activities in terms of, we had a scholarship called the Max Scholar, which is Mentored Academic Experience. That was a grant that was provided through NSF, and students were selected based on a criteria of listings. And then we had like weekend outings where we would go up to the Iron Range or we'd go up to the cities, but it's all geared around engineering. So there's tons of activities students would get involved in.
And
external impetus, if that's what they're looking for.
Yeah, that's great. I also know that especially our department has a draft racing team, and I feel like it's a lot of like hobbies in your major that you can do. Like I've been involved with women in STEM, and it's a lot of activities outside the classroom as well that's still kind of like this community. And I also feel like our department have been sending out a lot of like internship opportunities, and that's how I found mine. That's something great about it as well. Like they have contacts that we can take and also move on with, which is going to help us for future more than the academic learning.
Yeah. And in addition to that, I also lead a study abroad program. It's through the Dominican Republic, where I take students every year. And it's kind of based on three themes. There is the industrial experience. There is instructional. There's a project that we work on. And then there's a cultural components. So students head in with the students from the DR, and they work together and learn the different cultures, et cetera. So that's another avenue students could explore too.
Yeah, that's amazing. It's a lot of opportunities.
Yeah.
So the last question I have for you is, what advice for new students do you have to be successful in their courses?
Advice for new students to be successful in their courses.
Yes. What do you value as a professor?
That's a loaded.
Yeah. You don't need to. Feel any pressure to answer.
I'm going to chip at it because it's there's so much. I would say one, and that's something that I think sometimes students think that probably some professors don't really want to work with them, or they're on the opposite side of the field. Professors want to work with students. They want, ideally, all the students to succeed. Ideally, me personally, I would be happy if all my students got A's. But we have the empirical curve, which kind of, you know, most actual events kind of follow. So you have to break down based on A's, B's, and C's. But I think the number one thing is keep in mind that professors want to work with you. So use them as a resource.
Yeah.
Two, I think you have to quickly identify, you have to know how you learn as a student. And it's not something that's really taught at the various level of schooling. So I think students have to try to figure out how they learn and what works for them. After you've learned that, then you have to try to determine what you think that professor's teaching style is. Mm-hmm. So the closer those are meshed, the more transference there's going to be in terms of knowledge.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think the bottom is have fun. You know, it's an experience. Don't think of university or college as just academic. Think of it holistically. So it's networking, it's making friends, it's learning. I remember when I did my undergrad, I tried to get a lot of involved in public speaking things and leadership type roles, kind of like you're doing.
Yeah.
So I try to get involved in those things. And I think that's beneficial for students. If you know you have a weakness in a certain area, find things to do within those, how many years you're at university, to strengthen those things. Don't just think of college as, you know, academic, lecture, labs, and that's it. There are so many other things that you could do.
Yeah, I agree. And I really like that answer. It's about, I feel like it gets a lot of pressure on GPA at school, and you kind of take away your focus on why you're there. It's about the learn the academic, but you learn so much more starting college, like how to interact with people, and everything is changing all the time. So like you learn and like crucial life skills for how you even meet people in life. So it's not all about your grades and to be successful in that, because that doesn't matter by the end of the day when you graduate if you don't have a network or if you haven't like grown as a person yourself. So I really agree. And one thing that I focused on was how I learned, because I learned differently. I have a disability, I have dyslexia. So it was harder for me to compare with students how they studied. So I needed to find my own way, and also taking help of professor by letting them know and also asking questions. That is my main thing. You need to ask questions. Like you would never look at a student that they don't understand and are stupid. Like a student might feel when they ask the question, but there's no dumb questions. And it's really important to be able to ask those to succeed.
Yeah. Well said, Jacqueline.
Well, I really appreciate that we got these minutes with you so I could show the prospective students my favorite professor at school and also how we are interacting. Because I feel like it's kind of like this fear too, like you don't dare to go to professor's office hours because they're going to judge you or, you know, but it's really a great interaction and also a network that you build by having conversations like these. So
it is, it's a lifetime. So I'm sure we'll be in contact for the rest of our lives.
Yeah, I hope so.
And I know you're going to make me proud. So I would love to monitor your progress throughout our lives.